Venn-diagram. What is the downside of that package? You have to do all the calculations yourself. So all the numbers that you want to represent in your Venn diagram, you have to calculate them yourself. Using dplyr, for instance, that has functions that you can use for finding intersections and that kind of thing. So very often, that's not what you need. Yeah, some people do, but very often what you want to put in a Venn diagram are numbers based on lists of biological IDs. Gene names, for instance, or ensemble IDs, or SwissProt IDs. Yeah, you have multiple lists of gene names, and you want to see how many of them correspond. And that is what you want to put in your Venn diagram. Now, specifically for that application, there is a package called BioVenn. And the nice thing is that you simply give it your lists of genes. So this can be generated by analyzing RNA-seq data, by analyzing proteomics data, I don't know. So lists of genes. So you just give this package your lists, and he will do all the calculations for you. So he will see what the intersection is between these two lists and what the intersection is between these three lists. What is the downside here? You can only give him a maximum of three lists. Now, if you have four or five or six, it will not work anymore. But it's a really nice package. It automatically removes duplicates. So if your lists contain duplicates, he will throw them out. And it will automatically find the intersections. So, and this is the function that you need for doing that. So draw.ven, you give him the lists, and you can give titles for the plot, and you can specify what exactly he should put on the Venn diagram. So absolute numbers here. Yeah? You can also ask for percentages, for instance. If you have more than three lists and you still don't want to find all the intersections yourself, you can still go for this one, the Euler package. That will work with more than three lists. Now, what's the annoying thing there? Here you simply give him the lists, and that's probably what you have. So here you don't have to do anything. For the Euler package, the input data has to be in this format. So here, all the genes, and for each of your lists, you simply have to put if it's true or false, if it's in the list or if it's not in the list. And then you can use the plot function on the Venn function to create a Venn diagram. I'm going to show it because it will be more clear if I just show it. I'm going to load the BioVenn package. You might have to install it first, but it's a CRAN package, so it's easily installed. And then I'm just here creating three lists of gene names. So a lot of your analysis will generate this. So here we are. And then this is the function that you can use to make a Venn diagram here. So when we look at the documentation, you see that it's limited to two or three lists. You cannot go over three lists. And there's a lot of things that you can set here. I'm not going to go over all of them, but you. So I'm going to set a title. I'm going to set a subtitle. I'm going to give names to my Venn diagrams. That's what X, Y, and Z title are. And here I specify which numbers I want to see. That is here, this one. So absolute numbers or percentages. So when I run this, you need the BioMart package. It will not work without that. So the BioMart package is a bioconductor package. So to install bioconductor packages, you first have to install the BioC manager. That's easy. That's here. So BioC Manager, this one. Yeah, that's a Crown package. You install that one. And then you run this line of code. That will install the basic bioconductor. From the BioC Manager package, use the install function. And if you don't put anything here in between these brackets, he will install the basic bioconductor. So bioconductor is the part of R that is specific for bioinformatics analysis. And it works the same as R. You install the basic bioconductor, and then on top of that, you install additional bioconductor packages that are specific for one type of analysis. And then you do this, but instead of the ESEC2, you write BioMart. So with the same capitals as you can see in the error message. And that will install the BioMart package from Bioconductor. And once that is installed, you can use the BioVan package. So when you do it, he will show you the results of all the intersection calculations. So you save the results in a variable. When you look at that variable, it's a list, as you can see, and it gives you the list of the members of X, the members of Y, the members of Z, the genes that are only in X, the genes that are in the intersection of X and Y, and the genes that are in the intersection of all of them. Yeah? So you can see the results of all the calculations, and it will make you a Venn diagram with the absolute numbers. If you have more than three lists, you have this, and that should work without bioconductor, this one. So Euler is, here we are, a Crown package, so you have to install it, then you load it. But as I told you, to be able to use this one, so instead of just giving him three lists of G names, it has to be in this format. So we have to convert first. And you might think that this is horrific to do, to go from these lists to this, but actually it's easy, I will show. The first thing that you need here is a vector here, with all the genes that occur in all the lists. Yeah? Without the doubles, because you will have genes that appear in two or in three of the lists, so without the doubles. So you need all the genes that appear in the three lists without the doubles. So what is the best solution here? Using the unique function. So here you combine them, so you put the three lists together, the three vectors together into one big vector, and then you can use the unique function to filter out the doubles. So when I take a look here, you see that it's shorter because the doubles have disappeared. So unique, it's a function that you regularly have to use. So I'm going to store that in a variable. And then I'm going to create a data frame. So I'm going to use my G names as row names. And I'm going to create my columns. So for each list, I need one column with booleans. And in the beginning, I will only put falses there. I will change them. But in the beginning, I will only put falses there. So when I run this, I get a data frame with all my G names, my three lists, and a bunch of falses. Now, of course, now I need to change some of the falses into true. If a gene is in the list, I need to convert the false to true. How can I do this? And this is a beautiful thing here, this operator, the in operator. So What you do here is you check the row names of your data frame. Yeah, these are your all the names of the genes, all the gene names. And you can check if they are in list number one. So this part basically is a logical operation. So in is a logical operator, and it will return truths and falses. So true if a gene from your row names is in list one, and false if it's not in list one. Yeah, so this is perfect for what you want. Yeah, so what you do here is all the truths here. Yeah, you could use this, to be honest, as your first column. I made it a bit difficult. I can also convert my falses into true. So what will happen here when I do this? I get truths for all the genes that are in list one. And then I do exactly the same thing for list number two. So this logical operation will return truths and falses. True if a gene is in list two, and false if it's not. Yeah. So when I run this, you see that here truths appear. And then you have this one. I do the same thing for list number three. And here we are. So, and now I can use this function here to create my Venn diagram. Here we are.